afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your beautiful Fast Friday, July the 15th, 2022, Daily Bread Devo for today. Episode 781, Part 2. And in this one, we're going to be learning about the whole house. From wind collar derived from Acts 16, 22 through 34. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. And what does it mean, the whole house? Let me know your observation about what the whole house means before you get into the video. Let me know in the comment section. Before you watch the rest of this video, pause it, comment what you think the whole house means, and then watch the video and see if you're right. Come on, people. Start commenting on my videos. I have no comments on none of my videos. None. Well, I got a few comments here and there, but I'd like to see at least one comment every video. Please. That's all I ask. So, but subscribe if you do. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach a reasonable amount of subscribers by episode 800, which is now 19 days away. And also help me reach 100 subscribers by the end of summer. Middle of September. You know, on the calendar when it says fall begins, that's when I want to be at 100. So if you'll help me get there, I will appreciate each and every one that helps me get there. So, thanks in advance if you do. So without further ado, the whole house. Wind collar writes, wearing his striped jumpsuit, James walked across the steamy jail gym and climbed into a portable pool where he was baptized by the prison chaplain. James's joy multiplied, however, when he heard that his daughter Brittany, also an inmate, had been baptized the same day in the same water. Wow. When they realized what had happened, even the staff got emotional. There wasn't a dry eye, the chaplain said. In and out of jail for years, Brittany and her dad both wanted God's forgiveness, and together God gave them new life. Wow. Scripture describes another prison encounter, this time with a jailer, where Jesus' love transformed an entire family. After a violent earthquake shook the prison and the prison doors flew open, Paul and Silas didn't run but remained in their cells, Acts 16:26-28. The jailer, overcome with gratitude that they didn't flee, took them to his house and eventually asked that life-changing question, "What must I do to be saved?" Verse 30. "Believe in the Lord Jesus," they answered, "you and your household," verse 31, which says, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." So the response reveals God's desire to pour out mercy on not only individuals, but also entire families. Encountering God's love, they all came to believe in God, the jailer and his whole household, verse 34. Though we've often eager for the salvation of those we love, we can trust that God loves them even more than we do. And he desires to renew all of us, our whole house. So he wants to everybody, no matter what, he wants everybody to get saved. That's all there is to it. So what difference does it make to consider how God reaches out to whole families? And how can you trust God's mercy for your family? Let me know some examples that you've heard of in situations like that. Let me know in the comments. But ponder those questions by saying, if you feel like it, but ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen, so make sure your subtitles are on so you can see it. And in some chance, check the description if you don't see it. But here lately, it's been on the bottom of the screen. In my technique, I've been using some. But say, Dear God, please reveal yourself to my whole family. Short and sweet. So that one shouldn't take very much to get on there, even though I'm a day ahead. I'm actually recording this Thursday morning. I'm actually recording this Thursday morning at 5 o'clock. Or I'm finishing up at 5, so by the time I get ready to edit and all, it'll be set, it'll be on screen. It'll be on the screen when it goes live. So it'll be on the screen. So you should have seen it on screen, so don't have to worry about it. But today's Bible reading is Psalm 13, 14, and 15. And then the rest of Acts chapter 19, verses 21 through 41. So coming up tomorrow in your jubilant Saturday, July the 16th, 2022, your evening video, because of no turning point tomorrow, because my turning points are only on Sunday. The weekend devos are on Sundays. So, but for tomorrow's evening, part two video of episode 782, we're going to be learning about how we are useless without love from Lisa M. Samra, derived from 1 Corinthians 13, 1-7. And then coming up at 7 o'clock tonight is your last turning point for the week until Sunday. Your beautiful Fast Friday, July the 15th, 2022. Episode 292. We're gonna learn how we cannot withhold it. A little bit more about the Lord's Prayer. We're going to be discussing another part of the Lord's Prayer. But our recommended reading is Matthew 18, 21 through 35. Our turning point is from Philip Keller, K-E-L-L-E-R. And we're starting on the book of Isaiah in the Bible reading, chapters 1 through 3. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 7. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 7, for we cannot withhold it. Sounds like a goodie. So until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.